with everything that you have learned? What are you doing with your data? You are busy. Special apologies to women, but you're busy. You're waiting for him to cause. What are you doing? What are you doing? So let us talk about the kidnap of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. Why the government did that? How they were, because they came and they're trying to make it look like it is legal. It was absolutely illegal. But let's talk about that a little bit. But then I'm more interested in talking about what our people are doing. You love Nnamdi Kanu. You shouted my leader. You shouted the lion of Biafra. You shouted Ohama Adike. You did not see him right now. What have you done? You're coming to listen. Let me know what is going on. Let me know whether today said the government is arresting all the people who are talking about it. Let me wait. Is it safe now? There are more people talking about it than I can come and talk. I don't want to send gold out. You think about people like us. You think they don't know our addresses? You think they don't know our phone numbers? You think they listen to us? They know everything about us. And yet, we have continued to be consistent. So let's talk about it. And I have Mazi Simon Ekpa in the house. I'm going to also bring him on. Go ahead.
So I'm going to add this, and then I'm going to leave you. I'm so glad that Simon actually met us on the air, so it's not going to just be you. Okay, so that's why I would love us to touch that before I leave. Okay, sure. My one is up. However, how are you, Simon? You're right.
Yes, thank you very much. I'm just coming back now, and I think we're good to go.
Very well. So, it's good to have you, by the way. Thanks. You see, Dr. Chiri, Nigeria has committed a crime. All right, and I want to quickly add something. You cannot talk about Mazi Nnamdi Kanu and not become emotional. Dr. Chidi, okay? It's just how do you handle it, especially when people look up to you, okay? Well, as for our viewers, their emotion will always run as far as it will fit them, okay? And it is understandable that this surprise appearance of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu in Nigeria wasn't just shocking to the system of many. It also brought to fore our own callings, every one of us who has the opportunity of turning on camera, people listen to, it brought to fore the responsibility of us holding forth. They said if you want to strike the shepherd, okay? And that's exactly what they have been dreaming for years now, okay? A day where they will be able to hold him. People told them that once you get Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, all this IPOB thing will die down. But they were wrong. They held him for almost 2 years the first time. Instead of the IPOB to die down, it actually quadrupled. I think it was the moment they actually more members joined them. More sympathizers who were like, you know, the real Biafrans felt like, no, this is unacceptable. Now, the desperation of them taking Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is just an opportunity to make this Biafra to come faster than any of us, in fact, envisaged. It has also opened a new vista into the conversation about Biafra, from what it used to be, to what it was, to what it is now, okay? The new vista to this Biafran struggle is that every Biafran all over the world, right? They have rights to have a little bit of apprehension, doubt. It is normal. We are all human, okay? We all want to look forward to something to give us a little bit of hope. That is the vacuum that we, myself, yourself, Simon, has to feel. When we fill that up, give our people the hope, the real news, the real information, help them to process the whole thing going on, because there's a lot going on, all right? And this is what I'm going to do now. Nigeria committed a crime. Whether you are from the Biafra land, whether you support Biafra, whether you don't like Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, that they said they're looking for him for is a secessionist, as they call it, secessionist, which I would rather call self-determination campaign. They said they wanted him, but they don't believe in their own cause. They had him for over a year. They were running away from their own cause. Until when they finally were at least somewhat courage to take him to that court. And when he appeared in that court, he was released. He met his bail condition. He was meant to be free. But they said he shouldn't do this and that to get it in order to take him back in. That's a system that if they believed in it, that they believed that they set a trap for him, it was going to violate that his bail condition, which among them is that he shouldn't meet more than five people in a place. That's a trap. Then if you believe in that, your system, why not wait till the date of the next court appearance and revoke his bail condition and send him to prison? But that is not the agenda. They are holding an honest, innocent man in jail. That is in itself is a crime against humanity. Then they are now looking for something to charge him with. Something they can say, okay, this is enough to charge him. When they couldn't find one, they decided to kill him. He ran for his life. They said they declared him wanted in Nigeria. But Mazi Nnamdi Kanu reappeared 1 year later. Not just in the UK, he appeared in Israel. He appeared in different places. He was never arrested or intercepted by anybody. No. Because he was never wanted legally. Until they put up this arrangement that they called interception. In their own world, though, I don't care how they did it. All right? Theory. I have my own information about what transpired. But I'm taking them for their own words now. They said they intercepted him. He wasn't going to Kenya. He was traveling through Kenya, which simply means Nigerian government and Kenya government committed an international kidnapping crime that can actually make Nigeria become a pariah state. Something collectively in general will never be good for everyone that calls himself a Nigerian. But we have time and we are happy. You know why? Today, the UK Parliament is discussing the kidnapping and abduction of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. You see? The American Congress are looking forward to the day they are also going to discuss it too very soon. The United Nations that they said Amina Mohammed is holding forth for Buhari, that's not how things work. She might be holding forth, but it won't be for long, right? United Nations has reacted. There are many, 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 many other big shots that are yet to react, but they are aware. That is why I said, on the other hand, apart from us praying for him, showing our solidarity, support, and all of that, protests all over the world, encouragement on all platforms, right? I, Mayegun, can confidently tell you that your Biafra journey has taken a new vista. Get used to it. Something different is about to happen. The same rejected stone, the stone rejected by the builders, they say it, is about to be that cornerstone. And I don't know how it feels to be a Biafran. But let me tell you something. I have an attachment. When I received the news of his sudden appearance in Nigeria, a lot of things ran through my mind and my head. I lost myself, and I'm not even a Biafran, right? So I don't know how it feels like to be a Biafran. I can tell you this. Instead of you feeling so dejected, hopeless, in fact, this is the time you should all bond together than ever.
That's all right.
Doctor.
Thank you so much, my good general himself. I know you had only 1 hour to spend with me. I managed to push you to 1 hour 15 minutes. I know you're on the run, but thank you so much for being here.
I'm on, honestly.
Thank you so much.
But it's not gonna happen.
Okay, I'm gonna let you go, but before you go, I want Simon Ekpa to say one or two things to you. And before that, let me just share something here, just for everybody to know. Those of you that are in, if you are living in Toronto, we have two buses. We have two free buses going to Ottawa. We're gonna be at the British Embassy. We're going to be at the Canadian Parliament. We're going to be in several places in Ottawa, which is the capital of Canada. There are two free buses. And if you want to join, I don't know if they're still there. Maybe we're going to put a third bus. But please send by WhatsApp to 415-878-6563. The reason why we say send is that there are so many calls coming in. Of course, it is tomorrow. We are leaving here by 5:30 a.m. So please, it's first come, first serve. I just had to make that announcement. We're going to be in Ottawa tomorrow. Make sure that if you're interested, that you let them know. Simon Epa, please get our general as he takes leave.
Yes, Dr. Mayegu, General Mayegu, thank you for being part of this program. You have been doing wonderfully well and working for your Dudua, Yoruba, Biafra, and those freedoms, those who crave for their freedom. We thank you. We say stay strong. This is now the time, the most interesting time in the struggle for freedom of people in Nigeria and by extension in Africa. We are going to be, in a couple of weeks to come, we will be having more of joint program. So we are going to embark on a very ruthless sensitization of our people. It is time we are going to take a different level of this awareness for freedom of our people. We are going to be very, very ruthless. Ruthless in the sense that the media war will take a different dimension from now. So anybody who really crave for this freedom and know that freedom is the best gift ever should know that it is time to invest time, it is time to invest energy, it is time to do times three, times five of what we've done before, and to be able to maintain the propaganda, counter the propaganda that will be coming from the Fulani-controlled government of Nigeria. It is needed now. When you look at what has happened, you will find out that we don't want to start making a lot of analysis about this saga, because the more you make this analysis, the more you give them clue of how to solve the problem. You know, so we want to be to do the one. If they look me, and they look you. You understand? And people do not understand that. Thank you very much for having me. I see you.
Yeah, very all much. Right. You keep it up too, right? You are, in fact, a light that the Biafrans all over the world should be proud of. And I'm so happy that they all surround you and they support you a lot.
Thank you.
So you give them a new hope, something that somebody like me, 4 years ago, right, didn't really see coming. And you have done so well for yourself, speaking. So people should be proud of you, the Biafrans all over the world, okay?
Yes.
And yeah, keep it on.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, the general himself.
Thanks, sir. You have a good discussion, okay?
Yes. All right.
I'll be watching where I'm going. But thank you for having me. And
no
to everybody.
Problem. Thank you very much. All right. Bye-bye.
Yes. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Yeah. Okay.
You know?
It don't happen.
Dr. Chidi,
so my brother.
They look my time, because if you know how I'll be running around until I appear here.
I know. You have a very short time. So we're going to go straight to the point, okay? You're right, you have a very short end. The question is, with what has happened now, people are confused, people don't know what to do, what to say. There is a lot of misinformation going on here and there. So what is the way forward? What should be done right now?
The way forward, so many steps have been taken. A lot of things has been done on the ground for the best interest of our leader and for the best interest of Biafra and for the best interest of the movement. The IPOB leadership has done a lot, and a lot are going on ground. A lot of work are being done. Disregard the people that are carrying all those kind of fake frivolous and all manner of propaganda, trying to buy into the situation and in a bid to distract and make us lose focus. I am really happy the way Biafra kept calm, because the calmness we displayed shows that we are not idiots, we are not mugus. We don't need to delve into something when you don't have a first-hand knowledge or a first-hand information or fact before delving into it. The second thing is that the way forward is what you have just displayed on the screen about protest. You people have even hired a very big boss to convert people to the protest. That is the way forward. So it is they show, Biafrans. Yes, this is it. Biafrans all over the world, they are doing, the movement is being led by, spiritually. You understand? So the protest now is what we need. Very massive one. We need massive protest. The target should not just be only the embassy of the British embassy. The target should be the giant media houses and the parliament. This is very, very important.
Good point. Good point.
So where you are in Canada, make sure you target the biggest media house there in Canada, and everybody convert in the front of whatever the media house you have there, and make somebody come and pay attention to what is going on. And we are going to also go into paid advertisement. We are going to spend that money. Pay advertisement in all local media. So those of you in Canada that are organizing this thing, you have to look into that. Paid advertisement. Get in contact with all local televisions in your Canada. Pay advertisement to 30 seconds jingle, 30 seconds or 40 seconds jingle. Let it run. Let it run between now and 26th of this month. And then after that, we will now reassess it. Let everybody know, the local people in Canada, the local people in the United Kingdom, the local people in America, let everybody in the street that watches television at least see advertisement of Biafra and Mazen Nnamdi Kanu kidnapping by the Nigeria government, that we need world intervention. This is one of it. You see this war, the propaganda war and the media war, we are going to take it to a different. So let everybody know, because the point here is that as we are targeting the parliament, people voted them. There are people they're listening to. Apart from our lobbies, apart from whoever we influence, the way you are there, you voted for somebody, and the way you are there, somebody know you. You understand? So we need the locals. We need the locals who voted this representative to begin to make contact to them. We are seeing a very disturbing. Know that in Canada, it is not something that is going against media law and stuff like that. Advertisement, paid advertisement in television. It's not going to cost much, but whatever it costs, we want to see it happening locally, local televisions in the United Kingdom, in Canada, and the US, and some of the European
countries. Let me add something here, because people may be wondering, how do you come and be talking about certain things, just to support what you're saying.
Go ahead.
In country, I can write an advert and say that Prime Minister Trudeau is a very stupid man, and they will publish it.
Exactly.
In America, somebody, you hear Democrats say, Biden is a foolish man. He doesn't know what he's saying. And it will say, paid for by these people.
Exactly.
To publish it. I'm telling you, the police, the same police that is supposed to arrest people for not wearing masks, when there's an anti-mask campaign and all the protesters are not wearing masks, the same police will go and give them coverage or whatever, give them protection, even though they seem to be flouting the law. So I'm just trying to, it's a very good point that you have made. Let me ask you this question, right? Because people are gathered here now and they want to hear specific things. They believe that what they get here will be authentic information.
Go ahead.
Concerning the IPOB leadership, is everything together?
Is everything together?
Yes, because that's what people want. People think that they quite, although you touched about it, but they think, is it, why hasn't something happened? Why didn't it?
Of course. But what, of course, IPOB leadership, everything is together. The only people who may be thinking things are not together are those who are looking for the downfall of IPOB. And so anybody who suspects that everything is not okay, the person is looking for downfall or looking for gossip. IPOB is in position to come and tell you that everything is not okay. It is not you from the outside. So as it is now, that you have not been, if anybody said they have not heard from the IPOB leadership, that's a lie. The DOS was in Radio Biafra, made a statement, broadcasted. So you cannot say that the IPOB leadership has not given any voice. Like I said earlier, this is a very sensitive case, very sensitive issues that we do not want to go and give our enemy expo on how to carry it out, because a lot of mistake has been done. And the more we go into detail discussing it, the more they are going to see, they're going to see how to cover the mess they are into. And let me just make it very clear. As it stands today, Nigeria government have not come to tell you where they arrested our leader. We are going to leave it like that. People will be arguing, people will be shouting, they have not come to tell the world where they abducted, not even arrest, it's a wrong statement, where they abducted and kidnapped our leader. And do you know the reason? The reason that they want to hear from us. And we're not going to tell them.
Yeah, they want to know how much, but let me this. Simon, there's another thing that is pure common sense that I don't think people are understanding. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, who is the principal person who knows before anything that they did to him, maybe they gave him drugs, they made him unconscious, but time, anything happened. He knew where he was. He has met with his lawyer, if I hear Joffo. And they must have discussed. And I was analyzing this with my wife, and I was saying that even in their discussion, not everything will come out now, because wherever they're going to have that discussion, DSS is going to monitor it. They are going to record it. So even if he speaks in Igbo, they are going to hear. So there will yet be another time that certain secrets will come out.
Yes.
So you're right. They want to know. Well, so there are secrets right now that are still with Mazi Nnamdi Kanu that will still come out at the right time.
Let me tell you, Dr. Chidi.
Yes.
We are going to break the bone and the spinal cord of Nigeria with this particular case. We are going to break their spinal cord. We're going to break their back with this particular. Nigeria government has made the biggest blunder, the biggest mistake of all time. Remember that in 1984, when Buhari was the military dictator, he did the same thing, but it was a different case. Now the issue here is that if you listen to the federal government of Nigeria, they have not come to tell which security or agency they collaborated with. I want you to pick. These are very key point I'm giving you now. And like I said, we're not going to talk more.
Sure.
They have not come to tell the world which of the security, cross-border security agencies they collaborated with. We know that when you are having a cross-border operation, you are not going to engage a national police. You are going to engage the Interpol.
But Simon, be careful here. Are you sure? Remember that the first time Malami gave this information, he spoke to his people first in Hausa. Are you sure that time he was speaking Hausa?
Well, he did not talk to us now. Are you an Hausa person? Do you understand Hausa? You know one thing. I agree with you. You know one thing is that is where they tell the truth.
Exactly.
Once they go to that BBC house, every truth in them will come out.
Before he spoke to BBC, no. That's the mistake people make. People thought that Malami, first of all, that he was talking to BBC Hausa. No, it was the national address at which point he announced that the federal government had abducted Mazinandi Kanu. At that address, he started speaking Hausa.
Are you serious? You know, I have not come across it now.
No, I will send the video to you.
Please send it to me. We need to.
Oh my God, he spoke to these people. That he was, you see,
Yes.
Now, where people they have, they do overexcitement, and yet they come out. Out of overzealousness, now they were excited. He was going to make a very big announcement.
Yes.
He just broke into Hausa. We don't catch up.
Yes.
We don't, because so he was, he literally just exposed and unmasked how they feel about. He believes that all of us. I'm with my people. So the whole agenda, the whole project, the whole everything they are doing is for the benefit of a particular group. And so when he came to announce this achievement, he announced it to these people in their own language. Before he now remembered me and you are just non-entities, just to appease us. He now spoke to us in. So before you say they don't know, maybe they said it in Hausa. We need somebody to analyze it.
Dr. Chin, you have to send me the video so that I will bring people that will interpret it and they will translate it to us. But one thing is this, from what he told to us in English, you understand? From what he told to us in English, he did not say Interpol. You know, I did not hear him say Interpol. But rather, he said the National Intelligence Agency or whatever collaborated with their counterpart.
International counterpart. It's true. I don't think he said Interpol. I think it is us that just put Interpol there.
These are the thing. These are the thing that I want people to be paid. And we are not going to talk. Yeah. So these are the thing.
And he said interception.
He said interception.
Interception. So, meanwhile, Jofo came and told us that he was kept in Kenya. Mm. And you know, Kenyan government also came and said they had no day there. So there's a lot of mess.
Yes.
There's a lot of mess going on here.
Exactly. We are not going to the Hausa, the one he said in Hausa, we may have to play it and let somebody tell us what he said so that we can be able to understand whether it is different from what he said in English. Because usually in Hausa language they tell the truth. And we have
but
seen
you
it.
Know, me and you, you know, we that you know, say so when we tell people, they don't understand. This is how they see us here. So now we need to go and beg. It's like when the main people don't talk finish, we the people that are not in our entities now have to go and beg so that they can explain to us waiting on God. We are like, bros, we belong now, JB, all of us now.
In the same country,
do you understand? In the same country.
And like, when we are talking about diversity, people don't get it.
You understand? So now it's only one language that oh Jesus Christ! It is crazy. It is crazy. And now that we are talking about Mazinandi Kanu, I want people to understand, and that's why we are doing this program. This is not a time to be scattered. You are talking about a man who death is the least. Of the things that can happen to Mazinandi Kanu. Because for everybody else, I keep telling people this. When Omoyele Sowore says, you tell him some things, I say, Chidi, listen. Don't be deaf. I'm already dead, though. When you see people like Mazinandi Kanu, they were already dead long time ago. So you cannot use killing him to scare anybody. So this is not a time to be fretting. Oh, what if Nnamdi Kanu dies? One pastor even came and said, I saw Nnamdi Kanu in a coffin and all of those things. That is just uselessness. Right now is a time to keep a clear head, to remain focused, and to be happy, actually, that you are, the events that have happened are bringing us, because something must happen. Yes. It is now clear. Something got to happen. There is no more, even if you didn't know, something must happen. This case now has become like the fly as it specs in the bad junction where you hit it, you're in trouble. You leave it, you're in trouble. So something must happen. I wanted to talk to our people to understand that this is just a bend and not an end. And it's setting us up for the ultimate final battle in this whole thing. I love that. I love that. I love that. You know, when people see things, people, they see me with my family, they see me taking out time. They say, okay, Chidi, how can you be relaxed in this, in the midst of this whole thing? So why won't I be relaxed? Everything is happening according to plan. No, we're not scattered. We're not, see, agreed, like Maya Gru said, when it happens, because that's not exactly how it was planned, you get hit, you're shocked. But then, what makes a man, what makes a wise man, a brave man, it's not how many times you get hit by things, but how many times you're able to jump up.
And continue moving.
So we jump up quickly. And that's where we are right now.
So, Dr. Chidi.
Go ahead.
One thing I have to tell you is that from the way we, the IPOBs and Biafra people have composed ourselves in this whole saga, will make them to understand that we'll know everything they know. And some of the four points I may have raised here will also let them understand. It will send a signal to them that everything they have, we have it in our palm. You know, one thing is that the people that plan this thing knows the implication and the consequences of involving Interpol. The involving Interpol. Interpol is, you know, internationally well-recognized and respected security agencies. And like I said, in Nigeria, you have those policemen who are involved in Interpol. You have, in Kenya, you have policemen who are involved in Interpol. Let me just tell you, this man called Abba Kaere.
Sorry, can I ask you to do me a favor and do something for me here and something for our listeners? Can you explain to people what Interpol means and how it operates? Because people think Interpol is like, you know, they don't know it's made up of already existing established system. So explain it.
Our own is that when we talk about any, whatever we talk about, we don't just come and give you information, you know, even if we know what it means and all that. The International Criminal Police Organization, Interpol. Adam, give daddy.
I want this.
All right.
But wait.
So sorry that
no. Go ahead.
Our president is always on top of the game.
Yes.
The International Criminal Police Organization, commonly known as Interpol, is an international organization that facilitates worldwide police cooperation and crime control. Now, how Interpol works? Interpol works in a way that if somebody is declared wanted by member state, this is not, you don't have to belong to European Union to become the Interpol. Interpol is like, you know, like you just, the definition goes. Hey, Adam, don't disturb that there now. So like the definition goes, when somebody commits crime that is, you know, that involve maybe a cross-border, the person is somewhere, or the person, you know, declared missing, and the state where the crime was committed can declare, if they see it, you know, within the ambit of the law, of the international law, can declare the person wanted. And in a case like the self-determination, in a case like our leader case, Mazen Amikano case, Interpol cannot even declare him wanted.
Exactly.
Oh, yeah, yeah, go.
Exactly. Exactly.
Interpol cannot even declare him wanted because the crime he's being charged of has not been established, or there is no, you know, to have that kind of the requirement that will make the International Criminal Police to declare him wanted.
Exactly.
So, and that is the reason why when the Nigeria government are declaring IPOB terrorist organization, nobody is interested in listening to them because they know it is politically motivated.
Exactly.
They know the agenda of Nigeria, especially the Fulanis. The Europeans know. The people that make decision in Interpol know. These are people that highly intelligent security agencies, in collaboration with CIA, FBI, all these agencies. So if anything happen, for example, leader of Boko Haram is a terrorist group, you know, recognized all over the world. The leader of Boko Haram cannot travel anywhere without being captured. Let me give you one example. The example is when Buhari came to power.
Mm-hmm.
The time they started to import all these terrorists into Nigeria. You remember the man? You remember one sheikh that was arrested in Lebanon?
Mm-hmm.
Either in Lebanon, he got Nigeria visa to come to Nigeria. He was declared wanted, both by Interpol, both by all security agencies. He was declared wanted. Was in a wanted list. He's a terrorist, and he was coming to Nigeria to train this Boko Haram you are seeing today. He was arrested at the airport as he tried to flee to enter Nigeria with Nigeria visa issued to him. Buhari then ordered the probe of the Nigeria High Commission who issued the visa. The information is there in the public domain. So, if something like this happens, I want everybody to go to Interpol webpage. You are going to see the picture of wanted persons by Interpol. And when you look at it, you find out that even if you want to find somebody that is wanted by Interpol, go there. It is going to show there. If our leader were never declared wanted, there is not even a reason. In fact, it is not, that thing shouldn't even be discussed. We shouldn't be discussing it because there is no viability in, there is no, it is impossible. So now the only police that can get involved in this kind of operation is the Interpol. Now, the question is, where are the Interpol? Because that is the job of Interpol.
Why are they not talking?
What? They will not talk because they are not involved.
Exactly.
You understand? If they talk, it becomes the biggest mess on the organization, especially the organization in Africa. So the European will never trust them. The American will never trust them. So they cannot put themselves in this mess.
Big mess.
But this is the job of the Interpol. So we want to see, you know, that is why we, you know, we are watching them, they are watching us. You know, there is a kind of war, in the fight, you'll be fighting. When you fight, you know, you are looking for somebody to come and separate you. In those days, yeah, have you ever involved in that kind of fight?
You know, let me help you. When the fight is starting, they are holding you. You're
yes.
You want to kill the fight. By the time they leave you and you start the fight, you're not looking for somebody
yes.
to hold you again. Nobody
yes.
is holding you.
Some of us fought in those days that you will fight, and your hand will not be moving again. Because you have throat punches, and then you will stand, the opponent will stand. You'll be looking at each other. And you know, it is very shameful. It is very shameful. But the point is that who is going to make the first move
exactly.
in stopping? That you know, that is the problem. So once you make the first move to stop, your opponent already know when you give up. So he immediately, he don't want to struggle again. You'll be looking at each other. So what
let
is happening
say,
now?
Let me confirm what you're saying. You know, from when they abducted Mazinambi Kanu, they knew the deadline they had was until he met with his lawyer. So that's why they were so desperate to do so many things. They posted pictures, they posted a narrative video, all kinds of nonsense, because they knew that at the point, once he meets with his lawyer, all the lies will begin to be broken down. And that's what I was telling people that time. Said, stop guessing, don't bother yourself. When he has that meeting with his lawyer, everything will be, and immediately he had that meeting, do you not see what, like you said, the government is just waiting. The reason why they kept till 26, they are hoping that from that time to 26, some things will happen and they will go and hold it and say, you see this? Like right now, all the, like in Omo Eleshowore's case, when they arrested Omo Eleshowore, I can say this because I'm an insider. The same thing they accused Omo Eleshowore of, that he met with Mazinambi Kanu in New York. You know, I was waiting for that case to come up. I had arranged my ticket to be in Nigeria because it was going to be interesting. Here you were going to give information about a meeting that I was present in. So we didn't talk. Some of the things that we knew happened, we didn't say anything. And they kept probing. When they finally saw that they did not have anything to prove that point, they started dropping all their count of charges. The same thing is going to happen with Mazinambi Kanu. They drew up all those charges on him, hoping that from what do you think about his judge saying that he's not doing a game? What do you have to say about that?
I read the news. And if it is true, I am not surprised, because it takes Satan to stand and judge that case. Even to say this is going to be an insult to Satan, because you know those who worship Satan believe that Satan can do something to them, something good. So to use Satan as example, I am apologizing to those who are satanic. because some people believe in, believe me, some people believe in Satan, that Satan can do something good for them.
And it does. See, Satan gives you one hand. He collects it with the other hand. But he will do you good.
So what I'm trying to say in essence is that no normal human being that have human heart in Nigeria and call him or herself a judge will judge that case or even try to sentence Mazinambi Kanu, because there is no reason to do that. So what you see now, believe me, whoever they are going to bring to judge the case will still give up. Now let me tell you the propaganda they are doing now. The propaganda is that they want to, like I said yesterday in my program, they want to start to sell narrative. First of all, narrative that they want to inject Mazinambi Kanu. We don't need to be sharing that narrative. It is coming from them. They want to project it to see how people will react and whether it will, the market will sell. And they will start planning it.
Now,
they also want to project. Some people are coming. Oh, he is going to die. The prophecy is there. on the 25th, 51 days, he's going to die. All those things are lies, fallacies. It is coming from the enemy's den. The people projecting it may even demonstrate to be like the people with us. Let me also tell you another propaganda that I'm going to come with. I will be ready to counter and resist these propagandas. There is video making round now in the internet. They say Professor Geoffroy, Pastor Geoffroy has been declared wanted. It is a lie. It was a video of 2019.
Sure.
Now they went and brought out that video just to make sure they bring the propaganda and the narrative to sell to the public. Okay, let us put it and see how people will react. They want to, you know, this is old video. They say Professor Barrister Geoffroy and IPOB is being hereby declared wanted in Anambra State. It was in 2019. Now they have brought that video and they want to put it to the public. So many people did not see the video in 2019. So many people will not even remember the video. But it is also now, it has been uploaded again. So that when you watch it, it will begin to make wave. They want to see how people react. And then they will say, okay, nothing happened. No. Let us try it. Let us try to question Barrister Geoffroy. All these things is meant to bring distraction to the main issue, to the main problem. So that you begin to talk about it. And then before you know it, we are not talking about Mazen Amdekano again. We'll be talking about his lawyer.
Exactly.
So we must be ready to always debunk all this kind of propaganda that will be coming from their quarters, because they got everything to distract the fact that they have not told us where they captured him. They have not told us how and which security agencies collaborated with them. These are vital questions that we will be looking at them. They will be looking at us. this is something that I won't give answer. They must
answer this question. Talking about propaganda.
Yes.
Talking about propaganda. Let me.
Doctor Chidi, we have Doctor Chidi. We have Citizen AY.
Oh, Citizen AY is here.
Citizen AY is here. You are not going to see him. I think he joined my own.
I'm going to bring him. I'm going to send him something to come on, because yes. These are people who are doing well on their channel.
Send him and me. You know, my time in Agwam Kwarap. So as he's coming, I will be shifting.
No problem. Let me do that. Where the job we're doing is what we're supposed to do. So Citizen AY, if you can tell him I have sent him the StreamYard link. So
and let me address people who are calling Chidi stooge. Dr. Chidi is not a stooge. I think some of you look inward within yourself. If you are able to do what Dr. Chidi, who is a stooge, you call him, is doing, we will be somewhere, you know, either more better than where we are now. So you cannot always come, and when somebody shares a different opinion than you on a particular issue, and then still focus on making you and him go to a particular point, which is the end point, which is Biafra, you are still calling him a stooge, as if you are better than him. One thing I have to tell you people is this. Nobody trusts you that is commenting, not even your family. In your family today, there are things that will happen in your family, you will not be aware of it because they don't trust you. So you do not have any moral right to come here and start accusing somebody who have sacrificed his time, his intellect, everything in him, his brain, to come and start creating awareness, even if he don't believe in Biafra. Even if he don't believe in Biafra. But for the fact that he is bringing us, the Biafra people, on his program, that is a way to market Biafra.
So he's doing better than those that you think you can trust.
Let me say this. Now that we're talking about it, let me say this very clearly so people understand my position. We long before IPOB, or let me go back a little bit. People don't know my Biafran story, but I'm not going to bore us here. People, you can go to my channel and see how I was born. I was born right inside the Biafran war, right where they were bombing the hospital. I've said this a lot of times. My mother's stomach was still open when they brought me out and put me in a baby crib. The doctors were still going to stitch her from surgery. Her stomach was open when they started bombing the place. All the doctors abandoned my mother on the surgery table. My mother used her hand to grab her stomach and she rolled off the table in Omuahia, Queen Elizabeth Hospital. And she went to the crib where I was and she pulled me down. And with her stomach, she lay over me while the bullet and everything was happening. Mm. That is the story that I grew up. And the first time I knew anything as a human being, that was the story that was engraved in my brain. So you can't tell me about Biafra. Here in Canada, the people that started celebrating the Biafran remembrance, I was one of the pioneers. I, as an architect, I built the memorial that we normally use here in Canada. The biggest flag that we have, the Biafra flag, I sewed it with my own machine. Why am I giving this background? It's not for anybody to be impressed. But when we started this struggle against the government of Nigeria, we started it under the Take It Back movement. We came back here just like Mazi Nnamdi Kanu was trying to make the Nigerian government listen in London when he was even campaigning for restructure and telling them, why don't you people, with like you saw that video, everybody tried to work with the Nigerian government until we understood that these people, their agenda is bigger than what we are seeing. And things continue to develop. When people started saying, take it back, people say, you people are making noise. Come right back to Nigeria and let us see whether you can do it. We are following one line. We came back to Nigeria. I contested for governorship of Enugu State, trying to talk to my people. I never planned it, but as a way to prove that this thing can be done, I spent over $240,000. It is in my mind. Go and work out alone. Go and build billboards. Go and do all that before you come back to begin to try to understand me. At the end of the day, when it didn't work, we now said, listen, this government is not willing to listen to Biafra. This government is not willing to listen to even the person that believes in Nigeria. This government is wicked and evil. Let us pull this government down, Gabadaya. Let us do a revolution. Listen to me. Just like Simon has said, it is not, I respect your comments, but honestly, it's not your comment that's going to change anything at all. This is your comment that you write. This is your name that you're calling me. It's not going to change anything. Let me summarize by saying this.
You know, Dr. Chedi, let me cut you short. No, sorry. Yeah. You know, what people don't know is that there are so many ways to kill animal. There are so many ways. Some people kill animal by using gun. Some people kill animal by using trap. In those days, some people go to hunt for bird by using catapult.
Yes, sir.
There are some people that use gun, double barrel, to hunt for bird. Now, what I'm saying is that they don't know what you have done behind the scenes.
No, they don't know.
They don't know how you have participated in this struggle behind the scene, and that's what breaks heart. Because if I have not seen, you know, it will be a different thing, you know. But when you see people who have not contributed nothing other than going from one social media to another, coming to a live broadcast where you are hosting. Some of them don't know that, because this comment is not coming from you. You know? They don't know that you are the one hosting me. You know, they don't know. You are hosting me. And I'm live streaming it into my own platform. You know?
Okay.
So they don't know that you are the one hosting me. They don't know that. Adam, don't disturb daddy. They don't know that what you know, you are the one who invited me to your own program, and I am here now, and you are streaming it live to your own viewers, who also hear my own view about the way about Nigeria and the Nigeria state. So it is not like you are that I invite you here to come and speak. I am speaking on your program. So you are using your own channel to project Biafra struggle.
Exactly. People know, see, that's the funny thing people don't know. People don't know that my association with Biafra, my propagation of Biafra, my love for Nnamdi Kanu makes me suspect, according to Lai Mohammed, makes me suspect to people that I relate with in other organizations. Some people don't trust me because I propagate Biafra, but I don't have apologies to anybody.
Yeah.
And with that, we have our brother on the line, Citizen AY. You're welcome in our midst. I hope you can hear me.
I can hear you.
Okay. Mazi Simon Epa alerted me about you. And I just want to make sure that Simon understands. Okay, Simon. Now listen, man, Simon. You cannot be introducing me to a citizen. You cannot introduce me to Citizen AY. I will introduce Citizen AY to you. That's another deeper dimension that people don't understand. This struggle goes beyond what people can understand. And let me say this here before everybody. That Master Simon, only God will bless you for every risk you have taken, the effort. Amen. You know, people don't believe that you go to work. They don't believe that I walk. they don't believe that we walk. They just think all we do is just. And you know the one that pains me when people say, "Oh, you're doing this for the money, No. I live in a country. If I tell you how much I make and how much I spend, you will know that I live in a good place. Life is good here. This is very okay here. So don't worry about me. But let me really, really thank you for the job that you do. We appreciate you. This is an AY, you too. Thank God that we have come to a point where what we are doing is to be able to teach our people. And we must continue. We must continue.
Thank you, Dr. Chidi. As it is near where I come now, I have to do Zoom so that I will do the other thing I need to do.
My brother, I know you take two hours.
Honestly, I have another engagement that I have to finish.
Yeah.
Thank you, Dr. Chidi, for having me on this program.
Thank you so much, Master Simon.
All right.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Yeah.
So that's Simon right there. So, yeah.
Hey, Citizen AY.